Fundy Designer, it's possible to load your cover templates. Here we have our cover for this particular album. To view the cover, double click. We can adjust the cover by moving the image around and lining up with the cross here. To remove the guides, simply hit the G key or cycle through using the I logo at the top. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to create your cover template, whether you are using a direct lab or using a template from your lab where you have to input the size directly. If your preferred lab supports direct ordering via Fundy Designer, once you have selected the size of the album you wish to produce, you are then faced with the cover selection. Simply select the cover in which you would like to use and click Next. You can see here, in the album options, we've selected the Crystal Glance cover. Once you are happy, save the changes, and the cover you have selected will appear at the top here before the first spread. To view the cover, simply double click and you can view your cover and change accordingly. If you wish to add your cover from a lab template, then once you get to the cover options here, click the custom cover size link at the bottom just here. And this will bring up three options. The first is no cover. The second is a custom cover size, and we'll cover that in a later tutorial. But we're going to focus on this, the cover template. To add your cover template, click Select File. And it's here that you want to add the template that your lab has given you. Most labs will give you the file in a transparent PNG or Photoshop file, so simply flatten this and then import the flattened JPEG. You can see the file has been selected here. Once you're happy, click Next, and you can see that we have a template from a 3025 varnish ready to be imported. Click Save Changes, and then you will see the cover template has been added to your design. Now all we need to do is add our image to the cover. To do this, select the image and drag the image up into the cover template. Double click and then adjust where necessary. To see the guides, hit the G key or flick through the I icon. This grayed out portion here is where the leather will be on the binding of the album. The third way of making your cover is the custom cover size. To access this, when picking your album options on the cover section, click on the custom cover size and this is the menu you will see. We want to select the custom cover size. And it's in these boxes in which you enter the sizing and DPI for the cover. This album is being ordered from Graphy Studio in Europe, so the sizing is in millimeters. To change this, you select a different album size and a book line depending on whether you are in Europe or the USA. So I know that this album is going to be produced as a 30 by 20 centimeter album, so I have to input my values here in millimeters as stipulated in the brackets just here. So I need to enter 300 by 200. If you are unsure of the DPI in which you wish to use, then 300 is the safer option. We are fully aware that each album manufacturer's specifications may differ slightly, so it's always best to refer to your album manufacturer to get the exact sizing for these boxes if you are unsure. Once you are sure that you are happy with the values that you have inputted, simply click Next, and you can see that the cover is now a custom 300 by 200 millimeters at 300 DPI. Click Save, and your cover will appear before the first spread. To add an image to your cover, simply select the image which you would like to use, drag and populate the cover just like that. And this concludes the cover template tutorial, whether you are using an inbuilt cover, a custom template, or a custom size.